Dear student, due to coronavirus, school started online classes for your study. So you can subscribe Golden Flower Palia YouTube channel, like and press the bell icon.
Hello students of class 11th. How are you all? I hope you all are doing very well. So my dear students, today I, Mohammad Faizan Shamsi from the Golden Flower Senior Secondary School, is going to start the first chapter of the class 11th biology. So from the beginning of this chapter, from the beginning of the video, you have to just make the proper notes and you have to work hard. As you can see here, I have already written the matter on the board. The first chapter, that is the chapter 1, diversity in the living organism. It means in this chapter we have to study, I will discuss with you about the different kinds of the organism present around us. Different kind of the organism present around us. So let's start, that is the all plants, animals, humans, microbes are living. As you know very well, it is considered that on earth there is a living creature, they are plants, animals, microbes, humans. They all are the living creatures on the earth. They are all the living creatures on the earth. So we have to study in this chapter the differences amongst the different kind of the organism and the similarities between them, amongst them. Now, the next one is the biological diversity. It's a very typical word, biological diversity. Biological diversity, this is the term which is consists of the two words, that is the bio. Bio means living, logic means study, diversity means the enormous differences amongst the different kind of the organism. Enormous means a number of difference, a lot number of differences. So biological diversity, bio means living and diversity means the differences. So biological diversity are those differences, is the definition which shows, which represent the study of the different organism, that is called the biological diversity. Now the different kind of organism present around us shows biodiversity or biodiversity. It means whatever the kinds of the plants in and animals which are present around us, they are called the biodiversity. As you can see that whenever you are just going in a forest, or you are going in a park, zoo, anywhere, then you will see that there is a number of the plants which are different from each other. There are the different number of animals which are different from one another. Even a different kind of the different many species may be present of a single kind of the animal. They are called the biological diversity. Means whenever you are going in the forest, then you will see the different kinds of the larger, smaller plants. Few are medicinal plants, few are giving the foods, few are giving the different kinds of the material substances. So they are the differences. So that is why diversity means the differences amongst the living organism, that is called the biological diversity. So before beginning of the detailed chapter of this, before beginning of the details of this chapter, we have to study the general things related with this chapter. First top, another next topic is the what is living. As you know very well, sometimes you identify between a non-living and non-living things, that if anything is breathing, if any animal is taking the respiration or breathing process, you will consider that is the living. Otherwise, you will consider that is the non-living. But sometimes in some plants, you can't identify the respiration process or breathing process. So you will consider that a non-living. But due to the different scientific research, it is also considered that plants are also living just like us, and they are also following the different life processes just like us, just like the other animals. So on the basis of that, that what kind of the animals will be called as a living organism. Few points I have written here. These are the points. The points may be many more. The first point is that the all living organism grow. It's a very, very important characteristic of the living organism that all living organism has the process of growth. Every living organism will grow. Doesn't matter that is a plant, that is an animal, or that is a microbe. That is a different thing, but every living organism has to growth, right? Has to grow. Second one is the all living organisms reproduce. It's a very important characteristic feature because all living organism wants to maintain their generation on the earth. So to maintain or continue the generation of the organism, every living organism reproduce, means they multiply in their number, they increase in their number. That process is called the reproduction. So the all living organisms reproduce. All living organisms reproduce. Second one is the all living organisms perform metabolic activities. All living organisms perform metabolic activities. Metabolic activities, already you have studied in the class 10th also, that the different kind of the processes whatever we are following in our daily life to sustain life, like respiration, digestion, excretion, growth, reproduction, transport of substances, and whatever the process which are required, which are essential to sustain the life of organism on the earth, they all are considered as the metabolic activities. It's a very important characteristic of the living organism. Next one is the body organization, may be cellular, tissue level, organ system level. This topic already you have studied in the class 9th, when the body of the organism will form, as you know very well, when the body of the organism will form. So it may be cellular level, means just like you can take the example of amoeba, that only single cell perform the all metabolic activities. It means only single cell form the whole body of organism. So that body is considered as the cellular level. You will take the example of sponges, then that type of the body is also called the cellular level. In some process, the many cells are arranged to form the tissues. So in the tissues are having the capability to perform the different metabolic activities. So that type of the body is considered as the tissue level. But in multicellular animals, in multicellular organism, the different cells are categorized and they have to form a particular organ. So when the organism form their body on the basis of the organ level, it means there is a particular organ to perform specific function. So that type of the body is considered as the organ system level. So the body organization may be cellular level or tissue level or organ system level. Now let's come to the next point. That is the all living organism gives response to various stimulus. That is called the consciousness. So you know very well, stimulus already you are knowing very well from the previous classes. Stimulus means any change which takes place in the surrounding of the any living organism. Just for example, we are feeling the hot. We are feeling the hot when the weather is hot. When weather temperature is low, then we are feeling coldness. So just like that, if anyone is touching our body, then we will feel a sense of touch. So that is called consciousness. It means we are aware about the changes which are taking place around us. So that is why it is considered that all organism, doesn't matter that is a plant, animals, humans, microbes, all organisms are conscious about the changes around us or around them. Second thing, most conscious organism is the human being about themselves. About himself means the ह्यूमन स्पीशीज द ह्यूमंस आर वेरी वेरी कॉन्शियस अबाउट द चेंजेस टेकिंग प्लेस अराउंड देम अबाउट द चेंजेस टेकिंग प्लेस अराउंड देम दैट इज कॉल्ड द कॉन्शियसनेस दैट इज कॉल्ड द कॉन्शियसनेस आई थिंक दीज पॉइंट्स आर क्लियर टू यू नेक्स्ट वन इज द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ द ग्रुपिंग देखिए इन दिस चैप्टर आई टोल्ड यू दैट वी हैव टू स्टडी अबाउट द डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ द प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल्स आर ऑर्गेनिज्म विच आर प्रेजेंट अराउंड अस इन डिटेल फॉर्म सो वॉट वी हैव टू स्टडी फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव टू स्टडी अबाउट द क्लासिफिकेशन क्लासिफिकेशन इज द ग्रुपिंग ऑफ ऑर्गेनिजम्स ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द सिमिलर कैरेक्टर्स इज कॉल्ड क्लासिफिकेशन द ग्रुपिंग ऑफ ऑर्गेनिजम्स ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ सिमिलर कैरेक्टर्स एंड प्रॉपर्टीज यू कैन से इज कॉल्ड द क्लासिफिकेशन मीन्स वॉट वी हैव टू डू वेन द क्लासिफिकेशन आइडिया वॉज स्टार्टेड बाय द साइंटिस्ट एट दैट टाइम द डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ द प्रॉब्लम्स वर अराइजिंग दैट हाउ वी हैव टू स्टडी देर इज वॉज ए प्रॉब्लम to study the organism of different kinds of the organisms so that is why the scientists have started the idea of classification so that the study of the organism can be very easy so how the classification is started we will discuss in the next topics the grouping of organism on the basis of similar characters is called classification the grouping of organism on the basis of similar characters is called classification means we have to make a particular group so that the identification of the living organism becomes very easy so that the study of the organisms can be very easy these are the beginning topics previously these are the very simpler topics already you have studied in the previous classes after that let's begin with the next topic for the this chapter So the students, next topic is the need of classification. In the previous topic, we have studied about the classification, that why we have to study the classification. Now the next topic is the need of classification. Why we have need to classify the grouping of, classify or the grouping of the organism. So there is first requirement, that is the study of organism becomes very, very easy. When we will identify the group means when we will make the groups of the organisms, then it is very easy to us to scientists to make the study very properly. So by the grouping of organisms, the study becomes very very easy. That is called the first benefit. It's very special and very conscious benefit of the classification. Second one is the identification of organisms very easy means when we are making the groups so that we can identify the differences and similarities identification of the organisms very easy just suppose for example if anywhere we are looking any animal or plant so that we can identify very easily that the characters of this organisms is matching with that group organism so that we can identify the organism very easy second one is that it shows relationship amongst various living organism means whenever you will make the groups when you will follow the process of the classification so that you can identify the relationships between the all living organism very easily now the next topic is the taxonomy it's a very important definition related with this chapter that is the identification classification nomenclature and classification of organisms is called taxonomy. It is a branch of biology. बायोलॉजी. वन मोर थिंग, द यूनिट ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन इज, द यूनिट ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन इज कॉल्ड टैक्सा, इज कॉल्ड टैक्सा. इट इज द स्मॉलेस्ट यूनिट. सो वट आई एम टेलिंग यू, दिस इज द डेफिनेशन, द आइडेंटिफिकेशन, नॉमेनक्लेचर एंड क्लासिफिकेशन. आइडेंटिफिकेशन, जस्ट सपोज फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इफ वी आर गेटिंग द ऑर्गेनिज्म एनी वेयर इन आर सराउंडिंग, सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द वर्क इज दैट वी हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई दैट फ्रॉम विच ग्रुप देयर दैट ऑर्गेनिज्म कैरेक्टर इज रिलेटिंग. सेकेंड वन इज नॉमेनक्लेचर. नॉमेनक्लेचर मीन्स वी हैव टू गिव ए पर्टिकुलर नेम टू दैट ऑर्गेनिज्म, दैट इज कॉल्ड द नॉमेनक्लेचर. नाउ द सेकेंड वन इज द नॉमेनक्लेचर. देन क्लासिफिकेशन. क्लासिफिकेशन मीन्स आफ्टर द आइडेंटिफिकेशन, आफ्टर द गिविंग नेम नॉमेनक्लेचर, देन वी हैव टू पुट दैट ऑर्गेनिज्म इन ए पर्टिकुलर ग्रुप, दैट इज कॉल्ड द क्लासिफिकेशन. सो आफ्टर फॉलोइंग दीज ऑल थ्री स्टेप्स, आइडेंटिफिकेशन, नॉमेनक्लेचर एंड क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ ऑर्गेनिज्म, दैट इज कॉल्ड द टैक्सोनॉमी. टैक्सोनॉमी इज ए ब्रांच ऑफ बायोलॉजी विच इज कंसिडर्ड एज द क्लासिफिकेशन. द यूनिट ऑफ द क्लासिफिकेशन इज टैक्सा. जस्ट फॉर एग्जाम्पल यू हैव स्टडीड द यूनिट ऑफ द लाइफ, यूनिट ऑफ द ऑर्गेनिज्म इज द सेल. सो जस्ट लाइक दैट द यूनिट ऑफ द क्लासिफिकेशन इज कॉल्ड द टैक्सा. वी विल स्टडी इन द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक्स क्लियरली. नाउ सेकेंड वन इज सिस्टम्स ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन. सिस्टम्स ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन मीन्स व्हेन द आइडिया ऑफ द क्लासिफिकेशन इज स्टार्टेड. व्हेन द आइडिया ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन इज स्टार्टेड देन द डिफरेंट साइंटिस्ट, डिफरेंट बायोलॉजिस्ट हैव गिवन देयर आइडियाज फॉर द क्लासिफिकेशन. आउट ऑफ दैट वी आर स्टडीइंग अबाउट द स्टार्टिंग अबाउट द क्लासिफिकेशन. व्हेन द आइडिया ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन इज स्टार्टेड, आफ्टर दैट व्हेन वी विल गो थ्रू द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इट बिकम्स वेरी कॉम्प्लेक्स. नाउ द नेक्स्ट वन, द सिस्टम्स ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन अर्लियर इज गिवन इन द थ्री स्टेप्स. द फर्स्ट वन इज नेचुरल क्लासिफिकेशन. फर्स्ट वन इज नेचुरल क्लासिफिकेशन. सेकेंड वन इज फाइलोजेनेटिक एंड थर्ड वन इज सो वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द क्लासिफिकेशन. द फर्स्ट वन इज द आर्टिफिशियल क्लासिफिकेशन, सेकेंड वन इज द नेचुरल क्लासिफिकेशन एंड थर्ड वन इज द फाइलोजेनेटिक क्लासिफिकेशन. थर्ड वन इज द फाइलोजेनेटिक क्लासिफिकेशन. इट इज प्रपोज्ड बाय द वन साइंटिस्ट, हिज नेम वॉज प्लाइनी. इट इज प्रपोज्ड बाय द वन साइंटिस्ट, दैट इज वॉज जॉन रे. ओके, मीन्स these three classification earlier, first of all these three classification are given to classify the organism in the groups, that is called the classification and systems of classification. So first of all Pliny has given the classification on the basis of habitat like air, वॉटर, लैंड. ठीक है, सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द आर्टिफिशियल क्लासिफिकेशन वॉज गिवन बाय द प्लानी एंड ही हैज टेकन अ वेरी सिंपल आइडिया फॉर क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ द ऑर्गेनिज्म ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द हैबिटेट लाइक एयर, वॉटर एंड लैंड. मीन्स दोज ऑर्गेनिज्म हु आर लिविंग ऑन इन द वॉटर ही हैज कंसिडर्ड एज एक्वाटिक एनिमल्स. दोज एनिमल्स हु आर लिविंग इन द एयर, they are considered as the arboreal animals, and those animals who are living in the land, organisms living on the land, they are considered as the terrestrial animals. Means there is no complexity of the classification. He has included all kind of the organisms in one, those who are living in the water. So due to the after the failure of the this classification, the one more classification is given by the John Lake, natural क्लासिफिकेशन, नेचुरल क्लासिफिकेशन, बिकॉज ही क्लासिफाई द ऑर्गेनिज्म ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ इंटरनल एंड एक्सटर्नल एक्सटर्नल कैरेक्टर्स, एक्सटर्नल कैरेक्टर्स ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द इंटरनल और एक्सटर्नल कैरेक्टर्स. ही हैज चूजन द ऑल क्राइटेरिया टू क्लासिफाई द लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म, लाइक लाइक एनाटॉमी, लाइक एनाटॉमी, फिजियोलॉजी, मॉर्फोलॉजी, एटसेट्रा. All criteria he has chosen means he has studied all the characters which are showing by the organism internally or externally. After that he has given the classification idea. This is called the natural classification. Anatomy, physiology. Anatomy means with the branch of biology in which we are studying the internal characters. Physiology means in this branch of biology we have to study the different activities performed by the living organism. Morphology, it is the external characters, that how the organisms are looking from the outside, means all the complex points he has chosen to classify the organism, that is called the natural classification given by John Ray. After that, phylogenetic classification. This classification is given by, this classification is given on the process of phylogenetic characters. This classification is given by on the phylogenetic characters. Phylogenetic characters means what kind of the characters are called phylogenetic characters? Those characters which relate from previous species. So on the basis of the similarity of the previous species are called the phylogenetic characters. So this classification is called the phylogenetic characters. And about the more classification and about the more details we will discuss in the next chapter. Till that you can have study with the given notes. All the best.
Do self study at home and stay home, save lives. Thank you very much.